In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Holy words, long preserved for our walk in this world, they resound with God.
For our goodnight message on this Saturday, the 13th of May 2023, broadcasting from the Salesian community of the Sacred Heart in Lusaka, Zambia, by your servant Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco, we listen to this encouraging message entitled Scriptures to Help You When You Are Not Okay. In the ministry on Daily Bread, I receive so many messages, so many people going through a lot in their lives. And you know, we all go through so many kinds of seasons in life. Some are full of joy, while others are full of grief and sadness. But no matter what type of season you are in, it's important to remember one thing. It's okay not to be okay. And when we find ourselves simply feeling like we are not okay and don't know who or where to turn to, the one place that never fails is the Word of God. The Bible is full of scripture that can speak to so many different areas of life. But we also know that the Bible is a pretty big book. So I wanted to share with you a few places in God's Word to turn to and encourage you when you are not okay. And please be with the Bible as you go through tonight's goodnight message so that you can underline those passages. You paint them in different colors so that you know when to turn to them. When moments are gray, when darkness seems to be stronger than light in your life, when those friends you trusted brought you down, when the hope that was in you ceases to be, and when you have nothing to look forward to, there is something big to look forward to, the Word of God. Deuteronomy chapter 31 verse 8 to 9 tells us, "The Lord himself goes before you and will be with you. He will never leave you nor forsake you. Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged." He's going before you. Whatever it is you are facing right now, you don't even know if you have any road ahead of you. He is going to make a way where there seems to be no way. He will go with you so you are not going alone in your situation. Psalm 46 verse 1 to 3 says, "God is our refuge and strength, an ever-present help in trouble. Therefore we will not fear, though the earth give way and the mountains fall into the heart of the sea. Though its waters roll and foam and the mountains quake with their surging." This is a beautiful passage in the Psalms, and you know I've underlined that with orange so that it can be as visible as possible. God is our refuge and strength. If you have never been a refugee, you will not understand this. A refugee is somebody who has nowhere to run to, somebody who has no protection in his own country. And he runs somewhere else to look for protection. You don't need to run anywhere else. Just remain where you are and ascertain the fact that God is there. and it's going to be your refuge. It's going to be the source of your security and confidence. The other passage worth underlining is Psalm 145, verse 18 to 19. The Lord is near to all who call on Him, to all who call on Him in truth. He fulfills the desires of those who fear Him. He hears their cry and saves them. That's our God. He hears the cry of those who call on Him. And it is an encouragement to prayer. So that when you feel down, when you feel under the weather, when you feel like the world has fallen on you, get down on your knees in prayer, believing in the psalmist's assurance, the Lord hears their cry and saves them. Another encouraging passage that you need to highlight is Isaiah chapter 43, verse 1 to 2. The Lord says, "Do not fear, for I have redeemed you. I have summoned you by name. You are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. And when you pass through the rivers, they will not sweep over you. When you walk through the fire, you will not be burned. The flames will not set you ablaze." Oh, what an encouragement. This is the word that gives confidence. You're not sure what sort of waters you will pass through. You are not sure what sort of waves you will meet on the way, but you are dealing with the master of the wind, and he's going to handle everything that you are going through. The other passage is Jeremiah chapter 29, verse 11, where the Lord is assuring us of His plans. "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future." He has special plans for us. And those plans are not thwarted by whatever situation or circumstance we find ourselves. The other passage worth highlighting is Matthew chapter 11, verse 28, where the Lord is saying, "Come to me, O you who are weary and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest." His promise is real. There is so much peace in running to Jesus, in running to God in whatever we are going through. John chapter 16, verse 22 says, "So also you have sorrow now, but I will see you again, and your hearts will rejoice, and no one will take your joy from you." It is a promise of God in those little whiles when we experience pain and trouble. God says He will see us again. And may this keep you strong, and may it be an assurance that you're never alone. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Good night, as it dreams.
Same to you, Father.
Thank you.